We know that we have a lot of persons with disabilities in the world. In one of the latest estimates of the International Labour Organization, or ILO, they said that we actually have about 1 billion persons with disabilities all around the world. Most of them are working age people. Most of the persons with disabilities around the world are actually unemployed. The median rate for unemployment of persons with disabilities is 7.6%, which is higher than the 6% median rate of unemployment for persons without disabilities. So, ang sinasabi nun is, madami pa rin talagang persons with disabilities na hindi nasa workforce or hindi natin na-utilize yung talents and skills nila sa labor force.
So they defined disability as the interaction of impairment and environment. So persons with disabilities include those who have long-term physical, mental, intellectual, or sensory impairments, which in interaction with various barriers may hinder their full and effective participation in society on equal basis with others. Disability actually is an evolving concept, no? So disability results from the interaction between the person with impairment and attitudinal, environmental, institutional, and communication barriers that hinder their full and effective participation in society. So if the environment is a barrier, this can lead to disability. But if the environment is a facilitator, so this can lead to equal participation. So what is the difference of impairment and disability? So an impairment is any loss of psychological, physiological, or anatomic structure or function. Titignan po natin yung sa image dito. Merong matanda na naka-wheelchair, tapos nasusunog yung area niya. Tapos hindi siya makababa because walang ramp. So, yung kanyang pong impairment is orthopedic. Pero at this point, no, she is also in a situation of disability, no, because hindi siya makaalis dun sa danger na yon dahil wala yung ramp. So, merong physical barrier. No? So, an impairment on its own would not lead to disability should there be a completely inclusive and comprehensively accessible environment. Okay? So a good way to differentiate can be by reflecting on what are the root causes of impairment and disability. So yung impairment, for some causes can be attributed to accidents or sa birth, yan, sa war, natural disasters, medical negligence. For disability, root causes can be related to lack of access to an inclusive environment, poverty, poor educational and health opportunities, and discriminatory practice, no? Among us, among people. No? So in short, impairments are mostly irreversible, lifelong, and can be supported by rehabilitation and habilitation, whereas causes of disability are reversible, can be addressed by identifying and removing barriers to participation.
So we have national laws on disability, and one of the most important is the Magna Carta for Persons with Disabilities. So this law, among others, state that at least 1% of all positions in all government agencies, offices, or corporations shall be reserved for persons with disabilities. And the Act also encouraged private corporations with more than 100 employees to reserve at least 1% of all positions for persons with disabilities. So we actually try to advocate for this when we talk to company partners, especially those who are huge company partners with more than 500 employees. I also want to highlight the accessibility law, among others, that requires the construction of ramps, sidewalks, railings, and similar structures to provide persons with disabilities easy access to buildings. And just recently, there's actually what we call the Filipino Sign Language Law, This is RA1106 that declares the Filipino Sign Language as the national sign language of the Filipino deaf and the official sign language of government in all transactions involving the deaf. So the law mandates the use of Filipino Sign Language in schools, in broadcast media, and the workplace.
One of the challenges that we experience is first, the lack of technical knowledge. May interest naman, may willingness naman to engage in inclusion diversity program. Pero merong agam-agam that how do we do it? We don't know how to start, when to start. Second, maybe funding also, because they have programs but not institutionalized. Some of them are not really the priority of organizations. Disability agenda seems to be part of the CSR, Corporate Social Responsibility Programs. So, hindi siya ganun ka sustainable ang mga efforts kasi it might be at this time interest, pero sa susunod, hindi na. Another challenge is, of course, the changes in the leadership of companies. So, whenever there are efforts started, pag may change of leadership, nagbabago yung prioritization. So those are among few of the challenges that we experience.
Right. Siguro, dagdag ko lang din. Ako yung, ano ko, yung view ko is more of like within the community. So especially yung mga companies, di ba, very profit-driven. Hesitation, no, to hire person with disability is like, naisip nila lagi na merong kaakibat na cost. Kung yung big companies, ganun na mag-isip, what more yung mga small scale, like small medium enterprises, which are like, yun yung makikita mo sa community ng mga person with disability. Yun ang like, for example, a bakery, no? Na pwedeng puntahan ng person with disability to apply kasi that's, yun yung malapit dun sa community niya. So parang, may, yung perceived cost, yung nakikita nila. But the truth is like, hiring individuals with disabilities may or may not come with additional expenses, no? So for example, if you hire like a person na deaf or hard of hearing, no? Do you really need or do you required ba talaga na like every time meron siyang kasamang sign language interpreter? No, because we have like the basic communication tool, the pen and paper. We also have the modern communication tool. We have that your phone, your laptop, text messages, emails, yung very innovative na yung world natin na yun. And yung opportunities na yun, no, sana mag-benefit lahat sa atin.
Actually, it starts with a positive image ng company na yun. Hmm. Having a person with disability contributes to a more positive image. Sending a message na our company is an inclusive company, a welcoming company for everyone. So that's one. It also gives them recognition in a way. It may be secondary, but in our experience working with some companies, we tell them, you've been doing a lot of good work and it's about time that you showcase this good work of yours so that it will attract other companies, inspire other companies that they can do also the same. We have nominated two companies for a big event. It's a prestigious event and a national award. And it's something that we are very proud of because it boosts to the company also to hire more persons with disabilities. And one more thing is, I think ang pinaka-positive contribution then is there is that having people in their organization who are dedicated, keeping those employees in the company is something that is really an asset that contributes to the company.
Nagkakaroon ng innovation within the processes ng company. So for example, like in a team meeting, no, very diverse na yung mga thoughts, yung ideas, kasi different eh, very unique na yung mga ano, yung mga team members in the organization. Pangalawa, if like, no, if a company would like to create a product or a service that is accessible for everyone, meron na silang employee na pwede na lang itap na okay, no, baka pwede natin tong gawing inclusive sa yung mga kapwa person with disability. And so, sa pangatlo, no, sa innovation is yung workplace processes and procedures, no, hindi na siya one size fit all.
I'll start with efforts on increasing awareness on disability, because we believe that the more we know about something, the more that we know about disability, the more we understand the needs of persons with disabilities. The more we become sensitive to their needs, the more that we become aware of the appropriate support that we should give them, and the more that we engage in efforts that promote inclusion and diversity in the workplace.
But after raising awareness, sana nandun nandun yung will, especially for leaders, because they are the ones like really deciding if they will or will not hire person with disability. So sila yung parang game changer talaga doon sa kanilang organization, no? After the awareness, sana nandun yung will, no? And really turn the awareness into action. For the employees, no, like for example, magkaroon kayo ng teammate, a person with disability, or like colleagues, a person with disability. But how do we really communicate? It's like, tao sila, no, yun lang tatandaan natin, pwede kayo magtanong. Kung paano kayo magtanong sa iba, ganun din kayo magtatanong. Walang special something. Walang... So it's like, how you treat others is how you treat person with disability.